Good day, YouTube, Facebook fans. Today, I will show you how to prepare some garlic roll. Some simple, very simple garlic bread. And this bread will be made with the yeast that doesn't need to rise two times before you have a chance to bake. So the yeast I'll be using today would be this rapid yeast. The rapid yeast would be added to all the ingredients without having to proof it several times before you can bake it. If you use this particular yeast, this active yeast, then yes, you'll have to go through the process of mixing this with the warm milk and having it ferment for about 30 minutes. Then you'll have to have it rise before you can bake. This one, everything would be mixed, this rapid yeast, everything would be mixed together in one. And there'll be one proof at the end before we bake. So my next step would be to, as you can see, I have everything already measured out, pre-measured. So all I'm gonna do now is just take all of these ingredients, for the exception of the chopped parsley and my chopped garlic, and I'll mix them all together. So let's get started. So we'll use this mixing bowl. Now we'll add all my ingredients, which would be the sugar. And to get the right amount of these ingredients, you would have to check out the recipe in the description section right below the video. So you use the sugar, add the sugar, add salt, yeast, and the flour. Three things is not going to be added. It would be the butter, garlic, and the chopped parsley. So I'll add these together. We give it a little mix, get that turned in. And the only thing is we'll have to do now is add our warm milk. With warm milk. So don't believe because you get the word bread and it's so difficult to make. Following this recipe, making garlic bread would be a breeze. If you're best making a regular white bread, eliminate the garlic and the parsley, and you have the best bread that you can imagine. So now let's add this warm milk to this mixture. Then I turn on the mixture and let it do its thing. We would stop it. I just test the dough. It's a little sticky, but don't worry about it being sticky. That's the way it should be. next step would be after this is ready to mix, I would add in the same form, I would add the butter into this mix. Also add the parsley and garlic. Let this go ahead and mix itself. After the mixture, then we'll have it proof for about an hour. Then we'll bake it for 25 minutes at 400 degrees Fahrenheit. You can either mix this in a mixer, or you can do it by hand. By hand, it will take a little longer. Make a loaf and the remainder will be used to make half of this will be used for the loaf . But perfect. You should have some nice, tender garlic bread and roll. Just give this pan a little spray. So, leave this and let this proof for 1 hour, and then we'll go, it'll go into the bake oven and lay off about 2 ounces. Just on each roll. A little too big. Okay, good. Fun. Bottom lock, and we'll just palm these out. In the palm of your hand. Look like so. And you can just drop same thing here. With that rapid yeast, you waste no time, you save time on the proofing part of it. The one would normally take us about an hour, take us about 30 minutes. You can, after a while, you can get good. Or better, and we can start rolling them two at a time. Now that it is fresh, we can just set this in a warm area for about an hour for it to proof, rise a bit, and next we'll bake it at 400 degree Fahrenheit for about 25 minutes.